My dear brothers and sisters, once again welcome you to the Amrutvani TV program. I thank you for watching these programs regularly, and I trust and believe that you are being blessed through these programs. Today again, I want to share about the number 3, the topics related to 3. As I was doing for the past few days. Today I want to share about the topic called 3 types of houses. What is the relevance of these 3 kinds of houses? We all know, as human beings, we all need a house, whether it is a small hut or a big bungalow. Every human being needs a house. It is a basic requirement after food and clothing. Even the animals, birds also, they have their own houses. Now today, we are going to see, according to Bible, what are the 3 different kinds of houses we need to know. In the book of Hebrews, chapter 3, verse 4, it is written clearly, "For every house is built by someone, but he who built all things is God." Bible clearly says, every house is built by someone, but he who built all things is God. And Bible speaks about 3 kinds of houses. The first kind of house is the worldly house. The second kind of house is the spiritual house. The third kind of house is the heavenly house. Now we are going to see in detail about these 3 kinds of houses, how they are relevant to us even today. The first kind of houses are the worldly house, the houses which we live in this world, the shelter from elements, sun, rain, cold. So we need a house, which is called our home. We all need a house. Great people, rich people, poor people, everybody needs a house. And some people have big houses also. We know about a businessman in Mumbai who has a 27-story building as his house. So these are all worldly houses. Till we are in this world, we need a place to stay, sleep, live with our family. So worldly house is the first house, basic need of every man and woman. People are busy constructing their houses. If they are not able to construct, they go to a builder or purchase an apartment. as a dwelling place. You know, these houses are constructed by people, a builder, a contractor, or an individual. And these houses are constructed with mud, bricks, and cement, stones, and other material things. So a worldly house consists of all these material things. Big people's house consists of many other things, costly things. But it is an worldly house. It is useful for us till we live in this world. The second kind of house the Bible speaks to us is about the spiritual house. We should know what is this spiritual house is. In the book of Proverbs in the Bible, chapter 24, verses 3 and 4 says like this: through wisdom a house is built, and by understanding it is established. By knowledge the rooms are filled with all precious and pleasant riches. Here it speaks about wisdom, understanding, and knowledge. Bible says clearly, wisdom comes from above, that is from God. And knowledge is a man wants to build a house for his family. He needs knowledge. He needs what all needed, the finances, the materials, everything. And the third thing about a house is understanding is also needed. See, a spiritual house is built by a husband and wife along with the children. That is called a spiritual house. So, a worldly house is built by a contractor or builder using mud, bricks, cement, stones. But a spiritual house is built by two or more people. A wife, husband, and children. They come together. They build this spiritual house. This spiritual house is not built through some material things. It is built through love, understanding, cooperation, unity, joy, peace, which are found in the family. Husband and wife coming, understanding each other, and children also cooperating with the parents. That's why in this passage we see three different things, and the word understanding is used for the spiritual house. In English, the word understanding is beautifully quoted. What is understanding means? Standing under. A person humbling himself, trying to come under his position. Loving the spouse, especially wives and children, and all of them coming together as a family. Believing in God, trusting in the Lord Jesus Christ, and it makes a spiritual house. That's why we read in the New Testament, in the book of 1 Peter, chapter 2, verses 4 and 5, it says like this. I will read it for you. 1 Peter chapter 2, verses 4 and 5. Coming to him as a living stone, rejected indeed by men, but chosen by God and precious, you also, as living stones, are being built up a spiritual house, a holy priesthood, to offer up spiritual sacrifices acceptable to God through Jesus Christ. This is what spiritual house is called. Like living stones, husband and wife and children are coming and are being built as a spiritual house. This is a house where God's presence, God's peace, God's joy is felt. That's why we read in the book of Joshua, chapter 24, verse 15. The man of God, Joshua, says, "As for me and my house, we will serve the Lord." That means my family, me and my family, we will serve the Lord. That is a spiritual house. In the spiritual house, the family comes together. They fear God. They love God. They follow God. They serve God. And they are built up as a spiritual family. That's why somebody said, the family that prays together stays together. In a spiritual house, the family is a praying family. Spending time in worship and praise and prayer to God. That's why the family stays together. My dear brothers and sisters, nowadays you can see so many families, there are problems. Husband and wife, there is problem. Infightings, divorces. So many families are being spilt. They are earning money. Husband is earning, wife is earning more than that. But there is no peace, joy, unity in the family. That's why the children are suffering. When father and mother, parents, they are fighting. Ultimately, it is the children who are suffering. Children are becoming rebellious, disobedient. They are going astray. Now we know the age is a digital age. Children are behind. The mobiles, the new gadgets, they don't have time to spend with the parents. Parents don't have the time to spend with children. But in a spiritual house, they give importance to God and God's word. They come together and pray together. And also somebody says, the family that plays together stays together. Not only the family that prays together, but the family that plays together, the family that spends time together, parents and children spending time together, understanding each other's needs, encouraging each other, helping each other, that becomes a spiritual house. And third kind of house is the heavenly house. The first house is built by materials like cement, bricks and stone and mud, etc. Second house is built by husband and wife and children. Third house, the heavenly house, is built none else by God. God is the builder of this house. That's why we read in the book of Job in the Old Testament, chapter 30. Book of Job, chapter 30, verse 23, it says like this, "For I know that you will bring me to death and to the house appointed for all living." There is a house, heavenly house, after death. Many people, they are not bothered about this house. They think a worldly house, a bungalow, a apartment, it is enough. But more than that, we need a spiritual house. And more than the spiritual house, we all need a heavenly house. Word of God says, after death, we are going to heaven. The Lord Jesus Christ said in John chapter 14, verses 1 to 3, "I am going to my father's house where there are so many mansions. I will prepare a place for you and come and receive you to my father's mansions." So God is building a mansion for you and for me. A heavenly house, not with bricks or cement or stones, with precious stones, with gold and silver. A glorious house. If you have accepted the Lord Jesus Christ, if you have made your house as a spiritual house, then you have entry, then you have reservation for this eternal house. My dear brothers and sisters, Bible clearly talks about this eternal house. One more verse we will read from 2 Corinthians chapter 5, verse 1, which says like this, "For we know that if our earthly house, this tent, is destroyed, we have a building from God, a house not made with hands, eternal in the heavens." So, we have a house, eternal house, heavenly house, God is building for those people who love God, who follow God, who fear God, who serve God, who wants to go to that eternal house. My dear brother and sister, the Bible also clearly tells about the eternal house in very detail. God is building those houses for those people who wants to serve God, live for God. There is a story like this. There was a rich woman who had a big bungalow, big bank balance, and she was enjoying life in a great manner. She was a charitable woman also. She used to give help to people, donate money, everything she was doing. But she had no time for God. But she had a housemaid who was a lady who loved the Lord Jesus Christ, committed her life to the Lord Jesus Christ, and who was fearing God. So this rich lady kept this housemaid at her house. If any guest come, this housemaid will serve them with water and food and everything, lovingly, and share them the good news about the Lord Jesus Christ. But this rich lady was not bothered about all these things. She wanted name and fame. She used to help people. But she never bothered about God, about sharing the good news of the Lord Jesus Christ. One day, this rich lady saw a dream. In that dream, she was taken to heaven by the holy angels. Though angels took her around heaven, showed her the all great palaces, mansions, which the Lord Jesus Christ said, built with gold, silver, precious stones. And the angel was telling her, each and every house, who is the owner of each and every house. In one place, she saw a big mansion. So this rich lady asked the angel, "Whose house is this?" The angel told that rich lady, "This house belongs to your housemaid." The rich lady was very happy, excited. She thought, if my housemaid, very poor lady, who is living because of me, has this big mansion in heaven, how much big mansion will be there for me? Because I am doing so much charity, helping people. Then the angel kept on showing her different houses, big, big houses. Then in a corner, he showed that lady a small house, like a hut. This is a story, imaginative story. So, the angel showed her a small hut. And this lady asked the angel, "Whose house is this? How can be a hut be there in heaven?" That the angel smiled at her and said, "Madam, this house, this hut belongs to you." The rich lady was very angry. She shouted at the angel, "I know there is no injustice in heaven. God is not a God of injustice. He is a just God. When he can give such a big house, mansion to my housemaid, how can he give a small hut to me? I am so much a charitable woman. I helped so many people. I helped that housemaid also. This is injustice." Then the angel smilingly said, "Madam, whatever you send from earth, the materials, we construct the house in heaven. Your housemaid sent gold, silver, precious stones. That's why we have constructed her a big mansion. Now you have sent wood, straw, and all inexpensive things, because what you did in earth is for your selfishness, for your name and fame. You didn't do anything for God. You have no time for God. You have no time for Bible reading. You have no time for prayer and worship. That's why you have such a small house here. This is an imaginative story to tell us how we have to be careful when we are living in this world, this temporary world. Our mind should be on the eternal house, heavenly house. My dear brothers and sisters, I shared with you three houses according to the Bible. The first house is worldly house. We all need. We all have. Whether it is small house or big house, it is essential. But more than that, we need a spiritual house. We need a house where the family comes together, prays together, prays God together, spend time together. The presence of heaven is felt in that spiritual house. We all need that kind of spiritual house. And now we saw the third house, heavenly house. God is preparing a heavenly house for those people who are waiting for Him, for those people who are seeking Him, for those people who are pleasing Him, for those people who want to follow Him, for those people who want to live a sacrificial, selfless life, helping others. That is the eternal house. In this world, we may live maximum 100 years, or below that, or a little bit above that. But after that, we have to leave this worldly house. But where we are going? If our house is a spiritual house, we will be sure that we will be going to heavenly house. Nowadays, many people are booking houses. I even heard and read a news article that some people are booking the plots in Moon and even Mars online. I don't know how they are booking, how they will reach there, when they will reach there, whether they will go there or not. People are, they just want some plot, some piece of land, but they are not worried about the eternal house. They are not booking that place in eternal home, which is forever, everlasting. We all need to go one day there. Even if you don't have the worldly house, maybe you are living in a rented room, maybe you are living in a small hut, it is not a problem. But you need a spiritual house. You need a heavenly house. My dear brother and sister, now this is the time to think about the heavenly house, where we will go after our death. Bible clearly speaks in the book of Hebrews, chapter 9, verse 27. Every man has to die once, and after that judgment. Death is as real as life. We think about life, we ignore death. But death is as real as life. We can face death at any time. But are you prepared to go to that heavenly house? Have you reserved that heavenly house? If not so, today is the day that you can do the reservation, the booking for the heavenly house, by trusting and believing on the Lord Jesus Christ. Because Jesus Christ is the only person in the history of mankind who claimed that He came from heaven. And again, Bible says that He went to heaven. And Bible is telling that the Lord Jesus Christ is going to come back again to receive the people who have trusted him, who are faithful to him, who are following him, who love him, who serve him, to that heavenly house. He is going to come one day, very soon, to receive those people. Are you ready for that heavenly house? Bible says there is a rapture going to happen. Rapture means lifting up people. People who believed on the Lord Jesus Christ, who have committed their life, who are living a holy life, sinless life, they will go to that heavenly house. My dear brother, sister, now I am going to pray for you. Please do not be worried about the earthly house, worldly house. Be concerned about the spiritual house, which will help you to go to the heavenly house. Shall we close our eyes and look at the Lord Jesus Christ and accept him as the Lord and Savior to have a place in that heavenly place, heavenly house? Our loving and living God, the Father of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, we thank you and praise you, Lord, for this wonderful day you have granted to us, for the three houses which you showed to us through your holy word, the Bible, the worldly house, the spiritual house, the heavenly house. Lord, help us to be ready for that heavenly house. We know this world is temporary. This life is temporary. Any time we may have to face death. We want to make sure that when we die, or when you come and lift us up in rapture, we want to be in your presence, in the heavenly house, in that glorious house. Thank you, Lord, for making provision through your Son and our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, that whoever believes and trusts him will go to heavenly house. We pray for our dear brothers and sisters who have heard this message. Speak to them and make them partakers of that heavenly house. We give you glory and honor, and ask you this in the blessed name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen.